फेसबुक लाइव फॉर माय फ्रेंड्स इन इंडिया और इंडियन फ्रेंड्स वर्किंग इन पेरिस एंड फ्रांस. फ्रांस हैज बीन अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्लेस फॉर मी बिकॉज माय इनिशियल ट्रेनिंग एंड वर्क इन एंजियोप्लास्टी वाज डन इन फ्रांस इन रोआ रोआ इन नॉर्मंडी एरिया विच इज 100 किलोमीटर्स फ्रॉम पेरिस टुवर्ड्स द नॉर्थ. So I was working with Professor Alain Cribbiard from 1996 to 97-98. And 2 years down, then I had visited Paris. Of course, I must have visited France more than 55 times. And I have been, more than 75 times in fact. And I have been working for Apollo Hospital since 1998. So France is the second home for me and I have a lot of friends from, so I'm thankful to the organization Indians in Paris. Especially Mr. Rawat, who has been a good friend for a long time, and also Mr. Rao Sahu and other people, Saurav, who are working for this organization. COVID-19 has been a big problem and it is a pandemic. So I will try to give you some slides after a while. But before that, I would like to introduce further myself that I was working with Alain Cribbiard in France in Rouen, and I did the initial part of angioplasty. You saw coronary angioplasty is a life-saving procedure, which is better now than bypass surgery for the blockages of the coronary arteries. And this has been, at that time, the things were developing. And I was working, I'm basically from Lucknow, King George Medical College. My father has been professor there in King George. My father-in-law, doctor there also in King George. My wife is a doctor. My son is a doctor. My sister and sister-in-law. So everybody, so all family from doctors. And I have a lot of friends in Paris from cardiology. I've been attending EuroPCR conference in Paris since 1996 or 7. And this year, this is actually happening everywhere in Paris de Congrès, which must you all the people in Paris who are living must be knowing this area, Paris de Congrès. And this year, because of this pandemic, this is of course cancelled or postponed. We don't know whether it will be held in October or November. So I keep coming to Paris every year, at least sometime twice a year. I told you, I've been to Paris more than 75 times and I've been to USA more than 55 times. So it's my pleasure to talk about COVID-19 and also relatedly, what are the people who are affected, how France is affected, how India is affected, how world is affected. When Mr. Donald Trump was here about 2 months back, he never thought that he will be suffering from such a huge problem. In fact, he came during the corona time. The first case of COVID-19, corona, came in India in January 30th, and first mortality happened on 12th of March. Similar figure I don't know as of now, but of course I know, it is my pleasure to inform you that I also met Mr. Macron when he was in India. So I had a small meeting with your president of France, Mr. Macron, in relation to development of Indo-French hospitals in India. So we are working on that also, and we will try to develop some Indo-French activity in France also. So I have the friends all over the world, but especially France, I told you. So let me go on to my slides because it will take about half an hour to do my presentation. So what I will do at this point of time, I will have to, because of the Facebook technicality, I have to end my live video and then I have to restart this live with the sharing. So give me another 10, 15, 20 seconds. So I'm going to do it now. And I'm fortunate enough to know Mr. Narendra Modi ji, who is a now very important person for the whole world, Mr. Prime Minister of India. This is second term. Since 2010, I know him and I've been meeting him when he was Chief Minister of Gujarat. So he's doing a wonderful job. And today he has also Mann Ki Baat. I don't know whether you hear that. He talks on the radio and television, Mann Ki Baat, every month. He was talking about today that COVID-19 is a problem. So, okay, let me finish this and then I will come back with my slide presentation, because in Facebook, you can't have my picture as well as the slides at the same time. So this is a small thing. Basically, I'll immediately end the live video and come back to you within 20 seconds.
बर्थडे है उसमें,
तो छोटा कैसे करेंगे
उसमें
अगर ये कर देते हैं, छोटा दिखता नहीं ना फिर हमको ये। कोई बात नहीं, इसको लाइव गए नहीं अभी तक। आई थिंक यू आर एबल टू हेयर सी माई स्लाइड्स, आई एम एबल टू शेयर माई स्क्रीन। आई थिंक देयर विल बी सम लैग ऑफ 5-10 seconds and maybe I can speak to them. Okay, so I am back on the Facebook live with the friends in India. Oh, sorry, French, Indian friends in Paris or in France. So the topic is the webinar on COVID-19 and how the world is affected, how India is affected. So let me talk to you regarding this. So coming on to the slides, can you see the slides? And so my topic is COVID-19, SARS-CoV-2 preventive guidelines impact on cardiac patients, and this is a webinar. So coming on to the second slide now. Oh, how to change the slides? So global perspective is like this. Today, as of now, more than 29 lakhs patients all over the world are affected, and there are more than 2 lakhs deaths, and of course all over the world, and the recovered is about 8 lakh people have recovered. So coming on to the India perspective, coming on to the Indian perspective, 26,496 patients are infected today and more than 825 deaths. The French perspective is 1,61,000 patients are affected, 1,61,000 and 22 lakhs death. In America, the things are more worse. So I'm coming to the, what is the virus disease? I will talk to about you the virus disease. And what is virus and how everybody knows it, but I think a lot of people are here who do not know the exact what about the virus and how the virus affect. So if you see on this figure, you can see this figure that the virus first of all goes into the cells, and then after a few hours the antigen presentation is there, then there is cellular immunity and then humoral immunity. This is how the things work for and coronavirus entry and replication. I will give about 1 minute how to tell you how the virus is so dangerous virus and how it works and destroys the cells. Coronavirus S protein has been reported as significant determinant of virus entry into host cells. The enveloped spike glycoprotein binds to its cellular receptor ACE2 for the SARS-CoV and SARS-CoV-2. The entry of SARS-CoV into cells was initially identified to be accomplished by direct membrane fusion between the virus and plasma membrane. After the virus enters the cells, the virus RNA genome is released into the cytoplasm and is translated to 2 polyproteins and structural proteins, after which the viral genome begins to replicate. Then the viral particles germinate into endoplasmic reticulum. This is all biology, and I think it's a revision of those people who are doctors who will understand. While the virus enters the cells, its antigen will be presented to the antigen presentation. Just hold on for a minute. Hello? Awaaz nahi aa raha hai? बट कोविड हम चेंज कर रहे हैं, स्लाइड चेंज हो रही है कि नहीं हो रही है? ओहो, तो ये हाँ, तो हमको तो स्लाइड मूव ही नहीं हो रहा है ये, बिकॉज हमको जो हेलो नहीं, वो तो कर लेंगे, वो तो हो जाएगा, लेकिन वो भी कर रहा है, लेकिन वो दिख रहा है आपको? नहीं, मेरी चेहरा दिख रहा है इस समय? सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल नाउ लॉग इन विद माय मोबाइल, नॉट विद द बुक डेस्कटॉप। दो मिनट, मैं आपको 1 मिनट में इसको एंड करता हूं, एंड लाइव वीडियो, एंड आई विल लॉग इन विद माय मोबाइल। आप मुझे मोबाइल से लॉग इन करने के लिए मुझे वही सिस्टम करिए जैसे मैं कर रहा था, मैं करता हूं 2 मिनट में, है वैसे कर रहा हूं। आवाज आ रहा है? बस स्लाइड मूव नहीं कर रही ना, स्लाइड तो मूव नहीं कर रही ना। अच्छा, अब आ गया, ठीक हो रहा है? ओके, कंटिन्यू। ओके ओके, अभी कंटिन्यू कर देता हूँ। स्लाइड नंबर टू, मतलब स्लाइड मूव कर रहा है ना? ओके 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 ओके, कमिंग बैक, सॉरी फॉर द डिले। देयर वाज सम टेक्निकल डिले इन द फ्रेंच बिकॉज दे आर डायरेक्टली ट्रांसमिटिंग इन टू देयर इंडिया फ्रांस पेज ऑफ द वेबसाइट, सो दैट इज वाई देयर वॉज अ डिले। So coming back to the presentation, so you can see that currently we don't, currently the antigen presentation of SARS-CoV mainly depends upon the MSC. So I am going directly to humoral and cellular immunity. So antigen presentation subsequently stimulates the body's humoral and cellular immunity, which are mediated by virus-specific B and T cells. Similar to the common antiviral infection, the antibody profile against SARS-CoV virus has a typical pattern of IgM and IgG production. I think for the people of the interest of the audience, I am trying to skip these slides because these are very technical slides, and I will just go directly to the clinical presentation. But I want to tell you that you must be aware that there are very patients who become very sick, and these patients who become sick are because of the acute phase response. Patient with SARS-CoV is associated with severe disease of CD4 plus T and CD8 T cells. This is highly specific thing, but what is cytokine storm? Cytokine storm is a very specific thing. The report in Lancet shows ARDS is the mainly cause of death. Of ARDS means acute respiratory distress syndrome is the main cause of death of COVID-19. So the cytokine storm will trigger a violent attack by the immune system to the body, causes ARDS and multiple organ failure, and finally lead to death. I may tell you that of the whole 100% patients who are affected by SARS-CoV-2, 80% will recover. Of those 20%, the recovery will be slow in 10%, while 10% will have serious complication requiring ventilation, requiring oxygen therapy, and finally they will succumb and there will be death. This is what has happened all over the world. That is why we are very curious to know this new biology, new system. How to diagnose COVID-19? The clinical symptoms of signs of patients infected with SARS-CoV-2 are highly atypical, including respiratory system symptoms, cough, fever, dyspnea, and pneumonia. But we have to be also making a diagnosis with a nucleic clinical manifestation and nucleic acid detection test. So, what is nucleic acid detection technology? You must be aware that RT-PCR, this is RT-PCR, reverse trans real-time quantitative polychain reaction, which is a test which is done from the body, from the throat swab, is a most important diagnostic test. The authoritative identification method of SARS-CoV-2 is virus blood culture and high throughout sequencing of the whole genome. However, the application of high throughput sequencing technology in clinical diagnosis is limited because of equipment dependency and high cost. So what is more common is RT-PCR, which is coming from the respiratory secretions, which is the most common way of diagnosis. But there is another way of diagnosis, the radiological diagnosis in COVID. And you would like to tell you that sometimes the RT-PCR is specific test for diagnosis. However, it can be false negative. So this is very important that many times a lot of people who are actually very clinically, whenever there is a for the patients who are high clinical suspicion, that means they have fever, they have sore throat, they have cough, and still this test is negative, then we have to do a CT scan. And the high sensitivity CT scan is a very important test which will be possible, which is done to confirm the diagnosis. And the diagnosis of CT scan is typical CT scan images, pulmonary parenchymal ground glass and consolidated pulmonary opacities, sometimes with a rounded morphology and peripheral lung distribution. This is very important. What testing is the key to success? How? Because you know, the coronavirus is a disease which has been suffering and we have not been able to diagnose completely. So testing is the key to success. And how is India faring? There's a small article today in the morning that we have done, the huge number of tests has been done, especially it is done in India, is about the overall, the Delhi capital has done the best with testing more than 30,000 per million, sorry, 1,500 tests per million population. Overall, the country India is testing only about 300 people per million, but India in Delhi, it is 1,500 per million testing is done. Testing is the key to success, and I think America, Germany is number one, where they have tested more than 25,000 people per million, while US has done about 5,000, France has done 5,000 per, or about 7,000 people per million testing. So numbers are increasing day by day, and let me tell you how the medicines work. So whether you are able to see the slides or not, I have to check it because this is... Yes, so coming back to the slides, how the medicines work, radiological diagnosis, then this is testing is the key to success, how medicines work. You see, the overall, when there is a new disease for any virus, basically you have to have a good medicine so that you can cure, and that is for unfortunately lacking, and that is why we are not able to do the overall, we are not able to save the people. So if you see these people, if you see that this is the diagram, this is a diagram where we are able to see that how the virus is going there. The hydroxychloroquine is working at this level while antiviral drugs are working at this level. So I would like to talk about this hydroxychloroquine a little more, because it was a French scientist who has said that is a highly useful for the prevention as well as treatment. So the hydroxychloroquine, from the French perspective, there is a doctor, Professor Didier Rault in Marseille, who has recently given a study of 1,061 patients treated for 3 days with hydroxychloroquine and azithromycin combination. You see, this disease is not... You see, what are the treatment modalities? When the patient, normally you treat only with Crocin or paracetamol for the fever. If the patient is not deteriorating, then you keep in the isolation ward. You let the patient quarantine, and you see the overall that patient, 80% patient will only require a normal antibiotics and also the oxygen therapy. But after, once the patient is settling down, and those patients who do not settle down, then you have to start specific medicines in the form of hydroxychloroquine. The agenda in our hospital in Delhi is that whenever you have a COVID test positive, and then at that time, you have to, whenever you have a COVID test positive, you will treat the patient with, of course, symptomatic treatment with paracetamol and other antibiotics, a routine antibiotic. And the patient is treated also with some antiviral medicines and hydroxychloroquine. So, but there is something going on with hydroxychloroquine. There has been so much of doubt because hydroxychloroquine can also have some detrimental effect in the patients who are cardiac patients. So it was initially disapproved by the same scientist, Mr. Renaud from France. But recently, when April 9, he had a study completed, he showed the data that Professor D.T. Renaud releases the results of new hydroxychloroquine. And he said there is no cardiac toxicity was observed and good clinical outcome with 91% patients of treating very well, while the 46%, only 4% patient deteriorated and 5 patient died. That means only 4.4% mortality. Overall mortality, that means the death rate in COVID-19 is about 10% is the patient average.
is 10%. Those patients who are more than 80 years, they have a mortality of about 20%. Those who are heart patients, they have mortality about 15%. Those otherwise in general population is about 5 to 6%. In this, when the patient was treated with hydroxychloroquine and azithromycin, the patient, the mortality came down to 4.4%. This was a very important study, and similar study was done earlier in China, and they had shared that despite the small number, this was actually published in February. This was in February 2020, that means 2 months back. This was a study of 62 patients in February, published in from Wuhan, China University, Wuhan University, Renmin Hospital, and they confirmed that hydroxychloroquine is useful and therefore it should be given in all patients. But there are a lot of confusion created by USA these days, especially the US FDA. And you might remember, you must be reading in the newspaper in Delhi, in France also, and especially in Delhi, that Mr. Donald Trump was very, very aggressive in finding hydroxychloroquine. And they requested Mr. Narendra Modi ji, our Prime Minister, to not to block the supply of hydroxychloroquine, because for that time in February and March, there was a huge rush of hydroxychloroquine that it may be useful for Indian patients, and the Indians stopped the export. Then on the request of Mr. Donald Trump, the president of USA, it was restarted, and therefore a lot of hydroxychloroquine actually was given to, was exported to USA and also to other countries in Europe. So, but let me tell you what US FDA is a guideline like Indian Council of Medical Research and DCG in India, and I think INSERM in France, the Federal Drug Administration, in 28th of March, they said they should to permit the emergency use of hydroxychloroquine sulfate and only emergency use for this purpose. The EUA, at that time, the European Union had disapproved. The optimal dosing and drug was not known, and they said that to test the adults and adolescents who are more than 50 kg, so they were not very sure. And day before, only yesterday, April 25, US FDA again warns against use of hydroxychloroquine to treat COVID-19. So US, this is a news item which I'm reading. US states built stockpiles of hydroxychloroquine after it was touted by Trump as a treatment for coronavirus. The US FDA warned against taking anti-malarial. Just sit down and listen. So, United States FDA warned against taking anti-malarial drugs touted by President Donald Trump. Donald Trump as a possible treatment of COVID-19 outside of a hospital. The Trump has repeatedly stated the drug is possible treatment for COVID-19 and could be a game changer, seemingly based on anecdotal evidence. So what US FDA is saying, no conclusive tests have been completed to prove its effectiveness. FDA Commissioner Dr. Stephen, in a statement, we understand that healthcare professionals are looking for every possible treatment option for their patients, and we want to ensure that we are providing them with the most appropriate information needed to make the for them to make the best medical decision. While clinical trials are ongoing to determine the safety and effectiveness of this drug for COVID-19, there are known side effects for this medicine that should be considered. So, let me clarify again from my point as a doctor that hydroxychloroquine is a very important drug, and the Marseille trial from France has already shown with a reduction in mortality of patients with 1,000 patients. The only problem is that there are a lot of people who are cardiac patients. So in cardiac patients, one has to be careful. And my personal opinion is that hydroxychloroquine should be treated, because there is evidence from the science. There's evidence from the science that actually it helps at the level of hemoglobin, and where this coronavirus is very dangerous. It actually, what it does, it dissociates the heme from oxygen. You know, hemoglobin is a compound which helps in the cellular transmission of oxygen into the lungs. So what COVID-19 virus, which corona 2 virus is doing, that is dissociating the oxygen from heme and leading to formation of porphyrin. This is very clearly known. So hydroxychloroquine is working and effective at the level of porphyrin at the cellular level, and therefore it reduces the virus load inside the body. So this is how it is working. Only problem is that FDA has a warning that it should be used with caution in the patients who are cardiac patients, where in ECG you have to see the QTC interval. It can cause cardiac toxicity only in the patients who have a increased QT interval, and therefore my suggestion is hydroxychloroquine should always be used as the treatment of choice for the COVID-19 patients. One important thing which I want to tell you through this Facebook Live, that all the healthcare workers should also take it. Indian Council of Medical Research recently had a guideline that all the healthcare workers, means doctors, nurses, ward boys, housekeeping boys, delivery boys, doctor, the people who are working inside the pharmacy, inside the hospital, should take hydroxychloroquine as prophylaxis, prevention. The dose is not much, 400 milligram once a day for one day, and 400 milligram once a day, once a week for 7 weeks. Coming back to other point, now I will switch from hydroxychloroquine to the role of other medicines which can be useful is ivermectin. Ivermectin is a very important compound which is actually antiparasite medicine, antiparasite. This is the only medicine which has shown in vitro to be killing the COVID-19 virus within 24 to 48 hours. And this is the slide which shows that within 48 hours, this effect increased to 5,000-fold reduction of viral RNA in ivermectin treated compared to control samples, indicating that ivermectin treatment resulted in effective loss of essentially all viral material by 48 hours. Now, the hypothesis is the effect is likely through inhibiting IMPA, mediated nuclear import. This is the only medicine which is actually anti-parasite medicine, but still it requires a human trials. So human trials, this is an in vitro study. In vitro means this has been done inside the lab in the petri dish. Trials need to be conducted in human. The results from this in vitro study should not guide the clinical practice, but we require it. Very important part of the use of masks. I want to tell you, because there are a lot of non-medical people here, and I would like to stress again with this Facebook Live that the mask is most essential component. You see how to prevent, because this is a very dangerous virus. Why this virus is more dangerous than other virus? First of all, it has a 20% or 10% risk of death, which is very high risk of death. It is more than the risk of the cardiac death. It is more than the risk of any other virus. It is more than the risk of any cancer death. And death can happen within few days. I was talking about, there was a lot of articles, various articles have compared the death in India by tuberculosis is more than COVID-19 death. But let me remind you, that comparison is not practical. Why? Because the tuberculosis death is about 2 lakhs approximately per year in India. I think if I'm not to figure, may I not be 100% correct figure, because I don't remember. But it's certainly more than what COVID-19 is killing. But this is not a practical comparison, because the tuberculosis death happens over a long period of time. If the person contracts the tuberculosis today, he will not die tomorrow. He will take about 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 years. That means the person who is infected by tuberculosis in 1997 might have died in 2006. Or patient who has contracted tuberculosis in 2005 might have died in 2019. That means they have a time to live. While in COVID-19, if you get the infection and if you are in the high-risk group, that means high-risk group means that means either you have a low immunity, your age is more than 70 or 80, or you have a cardiac patient, you have angioplasty done, bypass surgery done, stroke patients, they have a risk of 15% and they will die within few weeks. That is the difference. Because COVID-19 will kill a person in few weeks time. It will not prolong to years what is happening in tuberculosis, measles or chickenpox. So this virus is very dangerous. So coming back to my slide, mask is so essential. Social distancing is of course very important, but how to prevent? Because when it came in Wuhan in December and then in January and February, people were little casual. Why they were little casual was because at that time it was known that it is only being transmitted through the sneeze. That means a droplet infection. That means whenever some person is sneezing or coughing, if you are nearby, that is why the concept of social distancing, which is actually a physical distancing of 1 meter, came. Today it is 2 meters, as told by Honorable Prime Minister and WHO guidelines. I am following the WHO guidelines. But I was the first person, I would say, I am very lucky that I was on television on 19th of March, 18th of March, and also then on 26th of March, and also then 29th of March, I said, at that time there was a major event which happened in Anand Vihar terminal of Delhi,
that lot of people who are migratory workers, they surrounded the terminal, and there was some false news that people will start moving out of Delhi. And about more than 1 lakh population came in one area, and that was a mockery to the social distancing which was already going on since March 24. In Delhi, there is a lockdown since March 24, and I think same time the France is also having. So on March 29, this event happened, and I was on television. I said, don't do anything. You cannot prevent them. You cannot do lathi charge. You cannot do a tear gas. You cannot spray water. What you have to do is just to tell them to wear a mask. So everybody does not wear a mask. I told them, it is on the YouTube, that please your hanky, rumal. Let police tell that everybody should wear mask, hanky on the mouth. And I also use the word angocha. And nobody at that time, everybody was actually laughing at me. And they were saying, what you suggestion you're doing, it will create panic. On 26th March and 18th March, I said that other than lockdown, if the people are coming out for essentials, if they're going to mother dairy, if they're going out, the healthcare workers, the people are coming, the maids are coming to work, everybody should be made mandatory. Even on 18th March, I said, or I spoke also on 26th March on television, that rumaling, masking or angocha should be made mandatory. And that time people saying, don't create panic, it is not important, because at that time people thought this virus is not airborne. WHO immediately few days later said it virus can be airborne. Today I was reading that it can also be in the particulate matter, which is PM particle. That means during pollution time we may have a research, because particulate matter PM25 and other particulate matter is very high during winter time in Delhi, the most polluted city, one of the most polluted city of the world. So let me coming back to mask. That means the final conclusion is, if you are going out, wear mask or hanky or angocha or gamcha for Indian people, and for French people, if they can afford mask, is always better. So I think I'm audible there. I'm again reconfirming from the French people that if you can call me on the landline to confirm that you are able to see my slides, then I will be very happy. So coming on to the next slide. So we had actually a talk on the Italian doctor's perspective, and we had a webinar with the Italian doctors on 15th of April. And Italy was the first European country to be affected, and first European country to be affected at that time. So I would say that let me wear the mask myself, there is no harm. So Italy was the first European country to be affected the most, and at that time the lockdown was not even in France and other European countries, and that was I think February. Why it happened we don't know, but there was some thought process that lot of Chinese people, they had one theory. Yes, are you able to hear me? Okay, that's good. I'll continue for another 15 minutes. Okay, good. So I was confirming from my French counterparts who are listening there on the Facebook Live, whether they are able to see me. So I was telling why Italy got affected.